In this video, I'll demonstrate the use of bitmap effect masks. Up until this point, all of the effect masks we've used have been simple shapes, like rectangles and ellipses, or complex shapes, such as polylines using Bezier or B-spline curves. However, it's also possible to use an image as your mask source, taking the alpha, the red, green, or blue, or luminance channels as the source of your masks. Follow along with this simple example. Locate the folder you downloaded, named Packs, and load the clip that you find there. Alternatively, you could find the folder in Explorer and simply drag and drop it onto the flow view. The clip length is 137 frames long, as we could see in the trim in and trim out. Change the global length to approximately 150 frames. The footage we're loading is 720 by 486, which is NTSC D1. Set your file frame format preferences from the default value to NTSC D1 if it's not already set that way. Do this so the new tools that you add will automatically follow this frame format. Click Save Changes in the frame format's preferences. When you view the image, Fusion will automatically view it in the correct pixel aspect ratio. The image we have loaded has an alpha channel, as you can see by selecting the display view and clicking the A button. Click the C button to return to viewing the color channel. Apply a color correction to the shot by locating the CC or color corrector button in the toolbar above the viewer. Click and drag the toolbar button into the view. This automatically adds the color correction tool to the composition as well as viewing it in the large display view. Go to the color correction controls and make an adjustment to tint the image. Push the image towards yellow or towards red, something obvious, so that it's easy to see. Now let's create a noise map using one of Fusion's built-in creator tools to moderate the effect of our color correction. Right-click on the flow, click on the Creator tab, and select the Fast Noise tool. View the Fast Noise tool in one of the display views and click on Control F to set the display to fit within the view. Now let's set up the Fast Noise tool. Change the detail of the Fast Noise to give it a little bit more detail. Scale it in slightly so that you have a little bit more density to the noise mask. And then you can use the Seeth control to cause the mask to change over time, or increase the Seeth rate to cause it to automatically change from frame to frame. The higher the Seeth rate, the more active the mask will be as it moves from frame to frame. Connect the output of the Fast Noise tool to the blue input, that is, the effect mask input on the color correction tool. Make sure you don't connect it to the green input, as the green input is used for color matching references. A little trick is to hold down the Alt key on the keyboard when connecting tools. This will enable a text list of available inputs on any tool. At first, the effect of our mask may not be terribly obvious. You can still see a red tinting that's been applied to our character. However, if you adjust the Seeth, you'll see that the tint varies from frame to frame, matching with variations of the effect mask that we're using. When you apply an image directly to the effect mask input on the color correction tool, or any tool, then a new control will appear in the Common Controls tab, the one that's marked with the little radioactive symbol. Select the Common Controls tab, and you'll see an option to choose which channel of the input images is used for the effect mask. The default is almost always the alpha channel, but you can also choose red, green, blue, hue, luminance, saturation, or coverage as alternative channels. Also notice that all the channels have a low and high threshold adjustment. As in almost all tools, these parameters are animatable and can be modified by various expressions. We'll stick with the alpha channel for this particular example. Connecting the output of an image tool directly to the mask input has its advantages of simplicity. However, you lose control over the mask that you gain by using an external bitmap mask tool. Disconnect the Fast Noise tool from the color corrector's mask input, right-click, select Add Tool, then from the Masks category, select Bitmap Mask Tool. Like most other mask tools, it's also available from the menu just below any viewer. Connect the Fast Noise tool's output to the bitmap mask. and then the bitmap mask connects to the color correction's mask input. At first, this has exactly the same result as connecting the color correction mask input directly from the fast noise tool. However, if you examine the controls of the bitmap mask, you'll see that there is additional values which we can use. The first value, levels, allows you to control the intensity of the mask channel. The second control, soft edge, allows you to apply softness to the mask and remove additional detail. You could also invert the mask or move it by using the center control to transform the mask slightly in space. As you can see, the bitmap mask tool provides additional layers of control over your bitmap masks. Whether you choose to use the bitmap mask is entirely up to you. Delete the bitmap mask tool and the fast noise tool from your flow. This time, we'll use the bitmap mask tool in a slightly more interesting way. Select Add Tool and choose Bitmap Mask from the Mask category. Connect the output of the pack's footage to the input of the Bitmap Mask tool and view it in the display view. Now, copy and paste a second copy of the tool into the flow. Connect the one bitmap mask to the copied bitmap mask. Now, take the second output of the pack's footage and connect it to the second bitmap mask tool. View the second bitmap mask tool in the display view. Set its paint mode from merge to subtract. Now both bitmap masks are currently using the exact same image from their source, so as a result, we're subtracting the exact same mask and we end up with black. However, if you now take the center control of the second bitmap mask tool and move it slightly, you can offset the two masks, generating what amounts to as a rim mask or edge mask for your object. Connect the output of the second bitmap tool to the mask input of the color corrector. See how the edge mask is being used to provide directional lighting on our 3D rendered image. Apply a little bit of soft edge to the edges of the mask and you'll have a very natural appearing directional light source as part of your shot. You will find with experimentation, bitmap masks are incredibly useful for imported or internally created masks for that extra control in your masking, especially when a single mask has to serve multiple mask inputs with varying results from a single mask source. Many fusion artists use the bitmap mask tool to every mask they create. This concludes our brief overview of bitmap masks. As always, for the most up-to-date descriptions and details on Fusion, visit manual.vfxpedia.com.